you will stand with me for the reading of the text. It's coming out of Romans 6. Romans chapter 6. Read verse 2, then I'm going to jump to 5 through 10. Verse 2. God forbid, how shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Verse 5. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death hath no more dominion over him. For in that he died unto sin once, but in that he liveth unto God. I'm going to read verse 11 too. Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead, indeed, unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Hallelujah. All right.
And you may be seated. I'm going to read to you two other verses from the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 24. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me.
Yes, sir.
For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. Mm. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Mm. I want to preach to you under the title, An Invitation to Your Cross.
Well, all right, man.
An Invitation to Your Cross.
Amen. And
when you crucify something on the cross, you crucify it to be dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well.
And I got this message by watching a movie. You know when the heroes in the movies die, mm-hmm. they take a lot of time for the heroes to die.
Yeah.
Anybody else that is not a hero, that is not important, that is not important in the movie or in the storyline, or they die so quick. But the heroes, they get a lot of time in the story to die. And sometimes they prepare themselves to die, and everybody comes over and they say their goodbyes, and they even get right with God. But they get a lot of time to die. And in that, you know, in that time, I was thinking to myself, you know, upon seeing so many of those things, so many times when they do that, I kind of got tired of it and say, die already.
Well.
Have you ever been to that place right. in a movie where you say, yeah, just die?
Yeah.
They are on the deathbed longer than they are in the story.
Yeah.
And sometimes you get tired of it, and that's when I got this message, and die already. Sometimes God gets so tired of people not crucifying themselves or not denying themselves so much and crucifying the flesh.
Yeah, well, come on.
And God is saying, crucify already. make that flesh die already.
Well.
And I got the message and I said, God, I don't want to put that as a title.
All right.
I said, I'll tell him.
Yeah.
Tell him to die already, but can I change the title? To an invitation to your cross.
Yeah.
An invitation to your cross so you can come and crucify the flesh.
With
Jesus, crucify the sins at the cross with Jesus so that they no longer have dominion over you. Jesus said this to his disciples. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. He took his cross. And in doing that, he showed you how to do it.
All right.
By denying yourself. Denying yourself. What does that mean, to deny oneself? I'm going to give you first history how he came up to this point. See, he was with his disciples, and he was asking his disciples a question. Who do men say that I am? And they started saying, well, they say that you are John the Baptist.
All right.
That you are Elias, or one of the prophets, Jeremiah even, so you can throw that in there too. And Jesus just cut to the chase and told them, who do you say that
I am? All right.
Now he was giving them the answer there.
He was saying,
I am. Remember when he told Moses, tell them that I am send you. He was telling them, who do men say that I am? Who do you say that I am?
All right, come on.
And I like Peter, because Peter just speaks what comes to his mind.
Yeah.
And he can be related to a lot of us. A lot of us that have faults, because Peter has his own faults too.
Amen.
And you know, in this instance, he was right on point.
Yeah. All right.
He's saying, thou art the Christ.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
The Son of the Living God.
Living God. Then.
I want to tell you, that's my Peter imitation. Thou art the Christ.
Yeah.
That was Peter. Amen. And Jesus said to him, and called him by his name, Simon. And he told him, blessed art thou, Simon, for Jonah, for flesh and blood have not revealed this unto you. But my Father which is in heaven did.
My Lord.
If Jesus says that to me, I get,
yeah.
I knew it. Yeah, I know, right? I speak to God, I pray to God, and Jesus himself is telling me that God has revealed that to me, and now I was feeling like, oh, I got something right. Something right. And then Jesus continues on to say, I also say unto thee, thou art Peter, meaning a rock.
Yeah.
Woo, the rock.
The
rock. Not the rock, but the rock. Stable and steady. And upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Wow, that feels real good.
My Lord.
If I was Peter, I was feeling out there.
Yeah, rock.
Yeah, pick him up a little bit, doesn't it?
Amen.
He will pick me up a little bit, but he being Peter, sometimes when you know you are up, you sometimes go down a few notches. And he charged his disciples that they should tell no man that he was Christ. that he was Christ. And then he went on to tell them how that he was going to suffer at the hands of the scribes and out of the hands of the priest of that day, and how he was going to be incarcerated, and then that he was going to suffer and die, and then resurrect on the third day. But Peter told them, no! Right away, Peter. There he goes again.
Yeah.
Peter, that rock. The rock. He said, oh, I have an authority to talk now. Peter took him. Thank you, Jesus. Said Peter took him and rebuked him. Jesus had just lifted him up. And now Peter's going to take Jesus and rebuke him. Some people rebuke the ones that is blessing them.
Some people curse the one that is blessing them
in their lives. And there is Peter again. But as such were some of us, right? That's how I was too. The Bible says that such were some of us. Peter said, be it far from thee, Lord. This shall not be unto thee.
Uh-huh.
It's like saying, thou shalt not pass from here. But, you know, it wasn't his plan. It wasn't his plan. It was not up to Peter.
Amen.
The plan of God is not up to us.
Amen.
All right.
The plan of God is not. Your cross is not up to you. God knows what cross you need. So this is an invitation to your cross. To accept your cross, to go to your cross willingly. But he turned and said unto Peter, get thee behind me, Satan.
Right.
Not only Peter gets called out, rock. First he called him Simon, which means unstable, by the way. Peter, which is a rock, a stone, and then Satan. In the same chapter, Peter.
Amen.
But as such were some of us.
Well,
keep that in mind before you judge Peter.
All right.
Thou art an offense unto me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. And then Jesus said unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself. That was the key, to deny oneself. And you know, Peter is so human, just like most of us. But, you know, there were some before him, like Job. Mm-hmm. Who remembers Job?
Mm-hmm.
The devil took everything he had.
Yeah.
And he was a righteous man, just like Peter.
Oh, yeah.
Just like Peter, but he had a cross to bear, to carry. And he was a heavy cross. But he was, just like Peter, you know, when he got everything taken away from him and except his life, he said, the Lord give it and the Lord take it away. The Lord knows the way that I have taken it. When I am crying, I should come out as pure gold.
Yeah.
But then he cursed the day that he was born, and he cursed even the priest that gave him suffering. And and then he continue with, I know my Redeemer liveth, and he shall raise again on the last day. But then he continued on to cursing, and then to ask of God to give him a reasoning for his cross, for his struggle.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes God doesn't tell you what you're going through, what you're going through, but, you know, it's all for your good.
Yeah.
It's all for your good. Even Job has something to be worked on. After everything that he had done for God, seemingly that he seemed like there was nothing that was wrong with him. God had something for him to carry, to work on. And, and it was so deep that he took a very heavy cross.
Yes, sir.
Some of us have a very, very deep, deep seated within us, something that we had to work on. And sometimes it's going to take a very heavy cross to carry, to take it out. So it is not up to you what cross you carry, but if God wants that thing to come out of you, He's going to give you a cross. He will help you through it, though.
Yes, sir.
So he told them about his cross. He told them about his cross to tell them, I'm going to go and carry my cross. And now I want you to do the same. And he showed them by example, and he carried the cross all the way, all the way up the hill, and he suffered all those things, showing them that he was denying himself, him that could have come down at any time from that cross. He submitted himself to that cross, and he's saying, for you to submit yourself to your cross, to your trials, to your sufferings and your tribulations, because your trials and your tribulations work at what? Patience. Work at patience, and patience work at what? And it's all for your good. It's all for your good to take that which you have and that you have crucified and having put to death, that old man that has to be put to death.
Yeah.
Remember the renewing of your mind?
Yeah.
It's a process.
Yes, it is.
And sometimes it takes a walk with a heavy cross on your back to work that process within you, to make you a better vessel, to give him the glory that he deserves in you.
Yeah.
How do I know my cross? What are you struggling with?
Well,
we all know the commandments. Remember that rich man that came to Jesus? Told him, I have done all these things as my youth.
Yeah.
I have done all these things. He said, one thing. One thing you lack.
Come on.
And that was a heavy cross, wasn't it? He went away sorrowfully.
All right.
He had much possessions.
Yeah.
What is that is so precious to you, that is so much for you that you don't want to give up, and your struggle with it in your Christian life? Already as a Christian, you struggle with it, you don't want to give it up. And it seems so heavy for you. It may not seem so heavy for others, but don't look at somebody else's cross. That is not your cross. Neither judge them, because then you will be judged yourself. You're bearing your cross, that one which you are struggling with, and walking with it. You know, those crosses were heavy.
I know.
Those crosses were heavy. They had to have somebody help him.
Yeah.
Because of how weak he was, because of all the beating and all the it wasn't just the wooden cross, the cross that he was carrying.
Yeah.
It was everything else, because he could have gotten out of it
at any time.
But he was doing it for us.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He was doing it because it was the plan of God.
Yeah.
Because it had to be done. The sacrifice, the perfect sacrifice, had to be done. And that sacrifice of your cross has to be done. All the way to the cross, to for it to be crucified, to be so it can be, so it can die.
Yeah.
So it can die already.
Yeah.
So that you are a better vessel, a better blessing to others that are coming behind you and are looking at your life, and now they see how that you took a step, and you kept taking a step towards the cross, and continue until you crucify that which you needed to crucify in your life. Now you are a lot better, and you are a better vessel, a proven vessel for God, and which gives glory to God.
Amen.
To God be all the glory of our trials and tribulations. We glory in tribulations. You know, as Christians, sometimes there are some crazy people that they tell me. They shout when they are in tribulations.
Well, yeah.
They shout when they hit their head.
Well,
they say, "Thank you, Jesus."
All right.
What kind of Christians are those that they go through something hard and they are thanking God and they still standing strong?
All right. Yellow.
All right.
Man, if I was out there, I want that kind of power. Only God can give you that kind of power.
All right, yes,
to stand the greatest crosses out there. And I remember this guy that he caught a grenade and he was going to throw it and it exploded in his hand. And it was a phosphorus grenade and he was burning and he fell on water and he was still burning in the water. And when he jumped out of it, he said, "I still believe in you, Jesus."
Amen.
What kind of Christian, what kind of power is that that will cause somebody to carry that kind of a heavy cross and still give the glory to God?
Amen.
Give the glory to God so that others can come to Him. That person that heard Him, he's got saved right on the spot. While his brain was burning, his flesh was burning. And that's something. Jesus said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone, but if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit." Much fruit. The fruit is on the other side of the cross. The fruit is on the other side of your suffering. But we have to get to that core.
Come on.
We have to get to the seed. You know, a fruit, the seed is on the inside. And the fruit can't really show its greatest potential until you get to the seed. And that seed is planted. Because there is a big old tree inside of that fruit. But you cannot see it because you just look on the outside. See our outer shell, you know, we may look good on Sunday. And dress ourselves and wash ourselves out. Take a shower and we look good and smell good and party good. But you know, the inside, God has to get to that seed within you so that he can crucify all the other things. Take it out. Because, you know, that thing is just going to die. The peels die.
Yeah.
The rest of the fruit dies. And it's worth nothing, but that seed, can see these words after.
Yeah.
If it's planted in good ground,
yeah.
That seed has a tree within it which would bear fruit.
Yeah.
See, at the end of your trials and at the end of your tribulations,
hey.
And at the end, on the other side of that cross, there is that, just like Jesus, that resurrection.
Yeah.
Of a new creature. That's what the Bible says, doesn't it?
Yeah.
We'll become a new creature. A new creature. That can give all the glory to God because, see, now it can bear much fruit.
Yeah.
And like someone says, you know, it's like a tree planted by the rivers of water, which give it for its fruit in its season. Mm-hmm. And the leaf also shall not wither. Because now you are transformed.
All right.
That seed within you has been transformed, has been planted in good ground, and now it's on the other side of the cross, it's on the other side of the tribulation, and now you can give much fruit and give all the glory to God, because He is the one that has made that work within you. But you have to take up your cross. You have to take up that cross and follow Him.
Amen.
Follow Him. How do I follow? Through every step, Richard. How do I follow Jesus through every step? You can give all the glory to God even in your tribulations. See, Jesus showed us how to do it. And He was telling them that He was gonna give us the Holy Spirit, that other comforter, remember? The one that helps you and reminds you and teaches you the Word of God. When you are walking with your cross, the Comforter will sing and will remind you that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. As you take your next step, He reminds you that you can do all things through Christ which strengthens you. And you, if you're feeling weak, the Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. So say or sing it. I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. As you're taking your step with that cross, the Holy Spirit keeps reminding you of the Word of God. It gives you strength to keep on going, so that when you have done all to stand, you're still standing.
Yeah.
And you still continue, keep on going, just like Jesus did. Jesus knew He was going to resurrect because God told Him in His Word. You will also resurrect and be a better vessel, but you have to carry that cross.
Yeah.
You have to carry that cross and follow Jesus. Just like all the disciples did, and every one single one of them. They still didn't receive the promise, but I know that they will, because I have read the end of the book. And we win.
All right.
That Satan, that deceiver, he has been defeated.
Amen.
Yeah. All those trials and tribulations that he puts upon you, they're just working for the better for you. But you have to carry your cross, not somebody else's cross. Not somebody else's cross. Don't look upon their cross, that's their cross. Carry your cross. This is an invitation to your cross.
Amen.